Hi, welcome. My name is Farabod, and in the next few sessions, I would like to walk you through a discounted cash flow model that I have built in Python. However, it would be inevitable for me to walk you through a discounted cash flow model and not mention anything about valuations or corporate finance. So in order to set the stage and prepare us for that discussions and that walkthrough, I borrowed some slides from Dr. Aswath Themodiran, the Dean of Valuation at NYU, and it's from his course in Valuation and Corporate Finance. Dr. Themodiran is well known in this field. He made huge amount of contribution to both corporate finance and valuations. He is very generous providing his course on valuation and corporate finance for free on YouTube. The link to those courses are here on this collab file, and you are more than welcome to go and take them and learn more about valuations and corporate finance in details. I am only going to cover the high-level concept on these topics. Another great article about discounted cash flow investment principle is Everything is a DCF by Michael Mabusin. Michael Mabusin is one of the best researchers and money manager out there. The link to that article and the audio file that he reads itself is in the hyperlink of this collab file. This collab file can be accessed with this link. I will leave this link in the description of this video. Essentially, it will be taken here to this folder in my Google Drive where it says the DCF model. This is the Python file where I have all the material, presentation, and the model and the code itself just in one file. The model is very much inspired and structured the way Dr. Themodiran teaches his valuation course, but it's in Python. That being said, you don't need to know how to code necessarily. As long as you follow the steps that I will show you, that you can just execute the code and provide the inputs to the model, you will be able to use the model. However, if you want to make modifications to the model, you're more than welcome to do so, but you got to know some coding. During the next few sessions, I will be covering investment principle, some corporate finance, such as corporate life cycle, the risk and return model that we have in finance. I will be walking through the model that I have in Python with the DCF. And at the last session, we will be going through a Monte Carlo discounted cash flow. It's also known as DCF simulation. It is very useful to deal with the uncertainty that comes with a discounted cash flow because we have a lot of assumptions that goes to the model. All models are wrong, some are useful. At the end of the day, garbage in, garbage out. We have to provide input to the model that are reasonable. And in order for deal with that uncertainty around those estimates that goes into the model, such as your revenue growth rate, your operating margin, how much you have to reinvest back to the business, and so on, we need to deal with that uncertainty. And I built a Monte Carlo discounted cash flow model where we can look into our uncertainty into this phase and deal with it instead of running away from it. So how did I come to learn about valuation and corporate finance? Well, part of it comes from my personal curiosity, where I was constantly curious how wealth is created, how it's preserved, how it should be spent as we get older. The other side of it comes from my professional journey. I did industrial engineering, and post my junior year, I was working for multiple portfolio companies of a private equity firm. The private equity strategy is buying businesses and then improving the fundamentals, the intrinsic value of the business, and selling it for a higher price. It was during my professional journey that I came to learn how value is created. I got to work across supply chain, inventory management, sales, R&D, and capital investment. I then later studied financial engineering, also known as financial mathematics, and worked at Google on deals and investments. I'm currently working in risk management at Chicago Mercantile Exchange. It was during my professional journey where I was presented an opportunity to invest in a private asset, a private business. Well, in a private business, I couldn't refer to Yahoo Finance or Bloomberg because there's no market quotation to see what the price is, and that's, you know, take it as given, that's how much I should be paying for. I also didn't have enough money to hire investment bankers or consultants from McKinsey, Deloitte, KPMG, or what have you, to come and walk me through 10 slides and tell me what to do about such an investment when they don't see themselves qualified and fit enough to make a $10,000 decision for their own money. That's another conversation for another day. So I had to honestly answer that question, how much I should be willing to pay up for that given asset. and what would be my expected return, or approximately what should be my expected return. I then later was considering buying a house. It's not about whether I like the place or what these similar houses in the neighborhood are being sold for. The question I was trying to answer is, how is the price relative to the intrinsic value of that residential place itself? And I know I'm perhaps among the unusual tribe where they think of a DCF when they want to buy a house. But I would wager if there was more unusual people around, a real estate bubble, great financial crisis in 2008 would have never happened. The oldest DCF model that we are aware of goes back to 600 BC, where Esau said, a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. And that's really the investment principle. That's the essence of the investment principles. In order for us to answer that question, we need to understand how many birds will be in the bush, when they will emerge, and at what rate we will discount them to present. We call it discount rate, to get the present value. Now, instead of birds, let's think about dollars, Singapore dollars, Canadian dollars, Swiss franc, Japanese yen, and so on. Everything is a DCF. And if you don't know how to write or execute code, I hope you would be able to follow along in the next few sessions where I will be covering the high level of these concepts and find them useful. Thank you very much for listening, and I'll see you in the next video.